How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And if you're looking for a free VPN for your Chrome, then you know I might have a few options here for you, but don't expect too much out of free VPNs. Before we begin, if you guys are interested in any of the VPNs mentioned today, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to know the ins and outs, the advantages and disadvantages of these VPNs. Now, when it comes to Chrome extensions, of course, you know, you're not going to be getting the full VPN, let alone using a free VPN. It's going to be even more limited. Now, I'm going to just be making quick recommendations, and then I'll move on to what I would personally recommend for a VPN for your Chrome, or just VPNs in general. Now, if you're looking for free VPNs, I would definitely recommend Tunnel Bear over Windscribe and Hotspot Shield, and specifically because Tunnel Bear has a much more solid no logs policy and a clean slate when it comes to their data collection history, and just generally speaking, you know, the audits they run and everything. They are a more secure VPN. I would definitely trust Tunnel Bear with my data over Windscribe and Hotspot Shield, considering they're all free VPNs. Not just that, Tunnel Bear will also give you access to all of their 22 country servers. They have 22 countries, and you'll get access to all of them, unlike Hotspot Shield and Windscribe, which will give you just access to a few countries. And of course, all of these VPNs will have bandwidth limits, because of course they're a free VPN and they're not going to let you use it to your heart's content. So that's the thing with free VPNs. And not just that, if you're looking for a VPN or a free Chrome extension VPN that allows you to unblock Netflix and perhaps obfuscate your data successfully if you're in China, you're not exactly going to be getting that with these free VPNs. You can't expect that much out of free VPNs, especially if you're trying to unblock Netflix. Netflix is already tough enough. And that includes other streaming services like Hulu, HBO Max, Amazon Prime, Disney Plus. You're not going to be able to access any of those with free VPNs. Now, these VPNs will do the job just fine, by the way, if you're, let's say, just trying to keep your data private and anonymous and secured while using, for example, a public Wi-Fi. What I would recommend personally is, rather than using a Chrome extension, just use the application itself, which will encrypt your entire connection and everything you're doing online, rather than just your browser. Maybe you don't have access, or you're not able for whatever reason to download the entire application, so you're just looking for a Chrome extension. And if you're looking for a Chrome extension, by the way, I would definitely recommend, these are the free recommendations, by the way, so Hotspot Shield, Windscribe, and Tunnel Bear. For privacy's sake, I would definitely recommend Tunnel Bear over Windscribe and Hotspot Shield. Of course, they all have a 10 gigabyte, I believe it's just 10 gigabyte bandwidth limit. And past your 10th gigabyte, you won't be able to use the VPN anymore until the following month. So keep that in mind. Now, let's say you're willing to invest in a VPN, in a paid VPN, but still you're not sure. Don't worry, I've got three very solid recommendations. And that'll be ExpressVPN, NordVPN, and Surfshark. Now, these VPNs are just very good and excellent overall. These are the top three VPNs. And if you're interested, by the way, I do have a top three VPN video, which you'll find down in the description below. If you guys are interested in learning more about these VPNs, as well as special deals and discounts. But overall, when it comes to privacy policy, speed, streaming and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features, these VPNs are absolutely top tier. ExpressVPN, NordVPN, and Surfshark. Now, again, what I would recommend is using the applications themselves rather than the Chrome extension. But if for whatever reason you're not able to use the Chrome extension, then these are still very good VPNs. So if you're trying to unblock streaming services, for example, a lot of people that are, let's say, trying to use a VPN through Chrome will be looking to either just secure their browsing data or unblock Netflix and such. So if you're, let's say, trying to unblock Netflix, I would definitely recommend ExpressVPN over all the other VPNs here, including the paid versions of these free VPNs and Nord and Surfshark, specifically because lately, Netflix has been cracking down on VPN traffic. It's been making things very difficult for most VPNs, except for ExpressVPN, which has been able to keep up with Netflix's blocks and anti-VPN traffic blocks. Now, the thing about ExpressVPN is that it is still able to unblock the United States library. Unlike NordVPN and Surfshark, of course, the United States library seems to be the most difficult library to unblock when it comes to Netflix because it is the most sought after library and it's got the biggest number of content, really. It's got a lot of content. And so Netflix is really just heavily cracking down on the VPN traffic, especially VPNs with US servers that are trying to unblock Netflix. So unfortunately, NordVPN and Surfshark are having a very hard time unblocking NordVPN. Whereas with ExpressVPN, all you need to do, let's say if the, where is it? And you know, I'll use the server, I'll use the Chrome extension here. So let's say if, let's go to the States, if the New York server doesn't work, you can try Washington, LA, New Jersey, and 9 times out of 10, if you just try a few more servers, you know, 4, 5, 6 servers max, you'll be able to reach the US Netflix library. Unfortunately, with NordVPN again and Surfshark, it's too difficult at the moment, but they are trying to resolve it. There's just no time, no specific time that is given as to when they'll actually get that resolved. So that's one. Of course, all of these VPNs will have the regular WebRTC blocking and everything when it comes to data leaks and DNS leaks. None of that will happen while using these VPNs. All ExpressVPN, NordVPN, and Surfshark are super secure, and there's no need to worry there. You've also got, well, of course, you're not going to get the full service with the Chrome extensions, but you'll be getting, you know, CyberSec, again, RTC, WebRTC bypass list here will let you choose websites that bypass the VPN. So that can be helpful if you're, for example, you just want to have a few websites that don't use the VPN while it's on. So that can be useful. And with regards to Surfshark, of course, you get multi-hop and static IP, which, you know, interestingly enough, you don't really get those with NordVPN, even though they are available in the regular application here. You just have to switch to OpenVPN and you'll get your dedicated IP in double VPN. What else are you getting? You're getting clean web, the bypasser, WebRTC blocker, and that's pretty much it, really. Of course, again, what I would recommend is using the applications themselves in order to secure your entire network. But if that's not possible for whatever reason, then yeah, you can just use these Chrome extensions, 3 of the best VPNs. Again, if you're interested in learning more about these VPNs, be sure to check the description down below for full reviews, as well as the top 3 VPNs video if you're just wanting to check one video. You'll also find links to special deals and discounts. And worry not, by the way, these are not free VPNs, but you do get a 7-day free trial on mobile devices with ExpressVPN and Surfshark. I believe you also do get that with Nord. Not just that, you also do have a 30-day money-back guarantee on all of the plans with ExpressVPN, NordVPN, and Surfshark. So it's really a safe bet when it comes to trying them out for the first 30 days. That'll be it for this video. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a wonderful day.